DNA is the blueprint for life on Earth. Just as the workings of computer programs are encoded in zeros and ones, the instructions for biological programs are written in the A's, G's, T's, and C's of DNA. This data is stored in a beautiful, functional structure known as a double helix. In order to use the information contained in DNA, a cell must convert it into a functional biological part, often a protein. The data must first be copied into an intermediate format called mRNA, which can then be used to produce new proteins. The mRNA seen here comes from a gene called MYC, and it produces MYC proteins. But what happens when DNA's data is corrupted? Many errors in DNA, or mutations, are neutral, but some can disrupt a cell's functioning and cause disease. Mutations that cause overproduction of MYC proteins can be major contributors to cancer. During the last few years, scientists at the Koch Institute and elsewhere have been using a new strategy called RNA interference, or RNAi, to try to silence cancer-causing genes like MYC. To use RNAi, scientists must first deliver a short, double-stranded RNA sequence called siRNA into the cell. A protein called Argonaut detects this double-stranded RNA and binds to one strand of it. Together, Argonaut and the siRNA form a complex that attaches to and destroys cancer-causing mRNA. RNAi holds great promise for the treatment of cancer. But so far, it has been difficult to deliver siRNA molecules into cancer cells. Working together, biologists and engineers at the Koch Institute are developing new methods and technologies to overcome this challenge.